Squeak, 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 squeak. We're going to do a nice short three-rounder workout today. What we've got going on is we're going to do 15 hang power cleans. Weight for the men is going to be 135. The girls are going to be going at 95 pounds. And then we're going to hit 15 burpees. So this is going to be nice, short, and sweet. Just hit it hard and hit it fast.
Here you go.
Okay guys, we're gonna break down the hang power clean for you real quick. So what Helsey's gonna do, she's gonna go ahead and deadlift the bar, stand to full extension so her hip and knee is all the way open. Okay, from here, she's gonna keep the shoulder blades retracted. She's gonna stay super tight through her midline. She's gonna dip shallow, keep the bar above her knee, and then she's gonna jump and catch with the bar on her shoulder. And then stand to full extension. That's gonna be a full good rep right there. Typically, especially with the Olympic lifts, when we try to shortcut things, we're actually going to make them more difficult for us. So if we really get into a habit where you don't want to really pop the hips too much, you're going to be really shallow in your hip to try to make it faster, you're actually going to make it more difficult because you're not going to be closing off the hip nearly as much as you should, like in this position, but instead staying upright here and keeping that hip open too much. That's typically one of the biggest things you're gonna see. So instead, we always wanna stay nice and smooth, let that bar drift down the legs just a little bit so we get that nice hip closure here. So then when we go to extend through the heels, we're gonna be able to drive that bar up nice and aggressive. Probably the other thing that we're gonna be seeing a lot, you'll see this a lot in competition as well, is after we've gotten the bar up to the shoulders, this is not a complete rep yet. We still need to stand to full extension and show control, okay, with the hips and knees extended and the bars on the shoulders before we can bring that bar down. Otherwise, it's gonna be coming up, and then we're gonna start to see that extension, but the bar's already coming off the hips, and that's gonna be a no rep. So what he's gonna do for the burpee, he's just gonna drop his hand straight to the ground, he's gonna kick his feet straight out, let gravity bring him down, okay? So his chest and hips touch the floor all the way, he's gonna press back up, he's gonna jump his feet back underneath him, and then he's gonna stand full extension, little hop and a clap at the top, and that's gonna be a good rep for the burpee. So if I'm gonna be coaching this class, okay, in a group of a lot of athletes, what I wanna do is make sure that my cues are being nice and tight, okay? So if somebody is getting into those positions we talked about before where they're not quite standing up all the way, I don't wanna slow them down and stop them. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give them a quick cue of open your hips, stand up, control the bar, something along those lines so they're gonna be able to continue to make progress through the workout to keep intensity high, but that they're also gonna be able to get a full repetition of the full range of motion that we want. The thing that I'm gonna try to avoid the most is actually slowing an athlete down in a workout this short because we want that high intensity. Now, if we get into a place where it's actually getting dangerous and their form is broken down so much that we could possibly see an injury there, then I'm definitely gonna wanna kind of pause them, tighten them up, and then let them get back to it. But I'm gonna try my very best to keep that intensity super high as a coach. Hey.
Guinness is the Irish Progenix. You take a load of it post-workout and about 4 days later you feel fine.
I can't wait for this post-workout.